Hello students, how are you and how's your study going on? I hope that you all will be fine staying home and doing your study at your home. On the behalf of Paramount Public School, today we are going to discuss a summary of our first poem or book Hornbill named A Photograph. Are you ready to learn? Let's start with our topic. A Photograph is written by Shirley Tolson. A photograph summary. Firstly, we will do introduction. Compares the internal state of nature and momentary state of humans. Internal state and momentary means outside state or the showing state. In the poem, poetess describes a photograph of her mother's childhood. In the photograph of time, it is the photograph of time when she went for a sea holiday with her two girl cousins. Also, poetess contrast between nature altering at the pace of a snail and the fast change of human life. This line means that the nature is changing very slow speed, like a snail move, but the human life is changing in a fast speed. Poetess remembers how her mother laughs at the photograph and feel disappointment at the loss of her childhood joys. It means that it is the time when poetess mother show her this photograph, that she loves to see the photograph and feel disappointed also in that she had lost her childhood joys. However, then the sea holiday was her mother's past, and now her mother's laugh is the poet's past. It means that when the mother show her daughter the same photograph, she laughed at that. Her childhood has gone now, but now at this moment, mother laugh is also a poet's past. It means that her mother remains no more. At different periods of time and with great difficulty, both resolve with their respective losses and the pain that involves in remembering the past. It means that firstly the poet's mother resolved that she will forget her childhood days. Then now poet is resolving that she will forget the memories of her mother. Besides, for the poetess, her mother's death brings great sadness and a dire sense of loss. Moreover, the painful silence of the situation leaves her without words. Let's discuss its summary. The poem begins when the poetess goes through her mother's photo that lay within the cardboard boxes. They were possibly uncared for sometimes. In addition, it is not in any frame, metal, etc. It means it is a photograph just kept in the cardboard. So the poetess portrays it as being susceptible to forces of decay. Now poetess portrays it so that she could save it from getting decay. In the photo, poetess mother seem edged mean covered by her siblings who are younger than her. Also, she highlights her mother's strength as she sports her young cousins. They all look into the camera when their uncle or brother photograph them. Moreover, they look happy and excited with their throwing locks. Locks mean hairs and pleasant smiles. It means they were looking at the camera and their uncle is photographing them and the girls are smiling by keeping their hands in the hair. Further, the picture shows the sea waves smashing at them. It means sea waves are smashing at their feet or legs as the young girls learn to keep up with the waves. So they are holding each other to keep them up. She, it means poetess, remains with the thought that, see, even in the motion, but her mother, motionless in the photograph, is able to resist the change as she has surrendered herself to mortality. It means that she is motionless, but her she is in motion and her mother is motionless. It means she can't resist the change. Even though she is not changing yet at fast speed, but her mother has changed herself into mortality. In the second part or phase, in her older days, her mother looks back the day at the sea. Moreover, she remembered her two cousins also and recalls the day memorized in the photograph. It means when her poetess mother got old, she also saw the photograph and she remembers her two cousins and recalls their weekends or the holidays there. Also, she makes fun of her and her cousins' outfits. It means their clothes. These lines have a tone of sadness as the mother tries to accept the continually motion of life as she grows older. It means in expression she was laughing, but she was feeling sad because life has gone so fast that mother has become now older. Looking back at her 12 years old age self maybe was an attempt to return to her childhood, which is a painful reminder of time and age. In the third part, the poetess remembering her mother as she died earlier. Further, the photo scripts a memory for both as it notes the mother and daughter together. It means in the third part, the poetess mother has died and she is remembering her mother by this photograph, which had joined a note relationship between them even after her mother has left her for forever. The poetess confesses that the photo bliss at imagining her mother's laughter, much like her mother's delight in remembering the day at the sea. It means that the photo is also showing her the emotion of her mother. But like the way her mother watched this photograph and makes fun or remember her childhood, it is also remembering for the author. Moreover, she notices that the time over since her mother's final departure is the same as her age in the photograph. 12 years. It means it is a 12 years time when poet's mother has died. Maybe it is a coincidence or an irony of life and death. Eventually, both poetess and her mother learn to accept the change and make peace with their memories. Even though they remind them of the briefness of laughter, happy moments, etc. It means they both have kept their memories in a corner of their life, like we put the things in the corner. Even these memories are briefness of laughter and happy moments. Although the death or end makes things go quiet and empty. However, the poetess find her mother died to be loud and inspiring enough to pour her feelings out in the form of a tribute and poem. It means poet described that even the death leaves a silence, but here the poet had got the feelings and she pour her feelings in the tribute or poems for her mother. Thus, when even though death finish everything, but her mother's death brings out new response in her. Lastly, she accepts silently her resignation to the final silence of the death. So, came to the conclusion. In a photograph summary, the poetess want to say that death is unavoidable, so embrace your life. Here are some words of vocabulary. Momentary state lasting for a very short time. Alter, to make something different in same way but without changing it, or completely to become different. Dire, very bad or serious. Suspectibility, the state of being likely to be affected, influenced or harmed by something. mortality, the number of deaths in one period of time or in one place. And bliss, bliss means perfect happiness. I hope students you got the summary. Thank you. Thanks for watching.